Welcome, bowling fans of America, to Virginia Beach, Virginia! We are live at the Virginia Beach Pavilion as the PBA and ESPN are proud to bring you the finals of the Ebonite Challenge. And now, let's meet our four finalists coming up in just moments. Is a PBA Hall of Famer with 24 titles. From Stockton, California, Walter Ray Williams Jr. The third seed is the only international player in the PBA's Hall of Fame, from Venezuela, Emiliano Monticelli. The second seed owns three PBA titles and nearly 60 perfect games, from Erie, Pennsylvania, Bob Learn Jr. And our tournament leader rolled a 300-game en route to his fifth title 2 weeks ago, from Tarpon Springs, Florida, C. Hoskins. And now, let's go to the booth. And now, let's go to the booth and a pair of PBA Hall of Famers, Mike Durbin and Marshall Holman.
Marshall, everyone is excited. It's back in an arena telecast. The fans are excited. The bowlers are excited. I'm excited. I'm sure you are, too. We're expecting high scores out of these four bowlers tonight. We don't know that for sure, but we do know that things are going to be a little different tonight.
Well, they certainly are, Mike. We're going to have the top, the second, third, and fourth qualifiers bowling in our opening match, and only one will go to the final match. And those bowlers are, in the fourth spot, Walter Ray Williams Jr., making cut after cut, telecast after telecast, going for his fourth title. Amleto Monticelli is our third qualifier. He won a couple weeks ago in Bay City, Michigan. He wants to win again. The number two qualifier, he's the man that averaged 282 in Erie, Pennsylvania last year. I'm talking about Bob Learn Jr. It's going to be exciting.
And the winner of that opening match, whoever survives from those three players, will take on our tournament leader, Steve Hoskins, who bowled 300 on television just a few weeks ago. The winner of that second match is going to be the winner of the Ebonite Challenge here in Virginia Beach. But we won't be done then, because we're going to have the Ebonite Challenge coming on after that. And that's a three-way battle for $10,000, winner takes all. But our bowlers are ready to go with the opening match. Let's get to the action. And there's just four lanes here in the pavilion in Virginia Beach, Marshall. We're using lanes three and four.
Boy, this is going to be exciting. Amleto Monticelli will be starting first. Remember, three bowlers, one game. Only one goes on to the title match. And they were striking a bunch in practice.
Just like that. Now, Marshall, the way this is going to work in this opening match is Amleto's obviously lead off. He'll bowl frames one and two by himself. And then the second place bowler does likewise right on around the horn.
And they'll just keep going until it's all over. I'm not sure whether Walter is going to be up next or Bob. We'll find out momentarily. But first,
Walter Ray is going to be second.
Walter Ray will be second. And Little Monticelli going for some early pressure on the opposition. So really, Mike, he's up by 10 pins and the other guys haven't bowled yet.
Interesting, too, because Bob Learn was our second-place qualifier. It was his choice where he wanted to finish. He wanted to go last.
He immediately, he said that last night. He said, I want to be the last.
Evidently, he wants to know what he needs. Walter leaving the 2-8.
Not only does he not strike to keep up with what Amleto did, but he leaves himself a difficult spare. Now, of course, everyone knows Walter Ray's nickname is Deadeye, and he's a great spare shooter, but with the lanes hooking on the back ends, as strongly as are here, Mike, I wouldn't want to shoot the 2-8.
Counted the boards over. He's shooting it off his strike line, Marsh.
Fade,
and it didn't.
All right, we'll see Walter Ray using his strike line, as you said, Mike, but the ball hooks early. It's gone.
So, Walter opened in the first frame, and he's going to be behind by, 21 pins already behind Amuleto.
Behind Amuleto, and he
hasn't bowled his second frame yet.
Cannot afford to get behind too much too soon. Nice comeback for Walter Ray.
Now we're going to look at Mr. 300, Bob Learn, with 59 sanctioned 300 games.
And watch how explosive he is at the release point, Mike. He really gives it all he has.
Three, six, ten.
Come on, get through it. Cut it off.
Now you could hear him. He's doing his own analyzation of his game, Mike. He said he cut it off. He did not get the ball projected down the lane. He'll throw hard and straight for the spare.
At the 3-6-10, no trouble. His wife, Stacy, looking on. And we see the size of the field, 118, a little bigger this week. Took 212 to cash, 212 and a half, I should say, and 217 to make the match play.
Good competitive scoring conditions this week. Should she higher scores today? And a good comeback for Bob Learn. So everybody struck on lane three, but only Amuleto Monticelli throwing a strike on lane four.
Boy, he can take a commanding position with two more strikes here.
Yeah, he can increase his lead to 20 with Bob Learn, who's in second place right now. 31 if he strikes. His deficit, Walter Ray's deficit would be.
Boy, I'll tell you what, you talk about a sprint. This is definitely, you better get out of the blocks fast.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more, Mike. This is a situation where you cannot be tardy at the line. You have to come out firing. Put pressure on your opposition. And just because he's got three in a row, that doesn't mean he's home free. I mean, he's got to continue to pressure both Walter Ray and Bob Learn. You see Amuleto's best finish. He won just a couple of weeks ago, the Mobile One Classic, Bay City, Michigan.
Four in a row.
Boy, that is high, flush, and lovely.
And Walter Ray gets up trailing by 41 pins. He's only in the third frame.
Take a look at Walter Ray. He's the first $2 million winner in the Professional Bowlers Tour. Pete Weber, also a $2 million winner. Got to stop. And it's almost too late for Walter this early in the game.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, oh, boy. Takes out a spare ball. He'll go straight at the baby split. Walter at the 3-10 and doesn't convert. He won his last six games and made it in by one pin. I asked him if destiny was on his side.
Well, it kind of feels that way. I really struggled in match play. I qualified really well, and then the first round of match play, things just didn't go my way. In second round, they weren't going my way. And I started out the first two games last night with 508 and lost both games. So I was thinking, this is just not working out. And then all of a sudden, I started winning my matches, won a couple of close ones. Guys gave me some breaks. And to sneak in by one pin, that's godsend. So, you know, maybe I'm destined to win. But I got my work cut out for him. I got some good players to bowl.
Well, he definitely has his work cut out for him now with three opens in four frames, trailing by over 60 pins. Learn, though, can keep Amuleto within range with a couple of strikes.
If Bob Learn does not strike in this frame, and then Amuleto comes up and puts more heat on him, this game could be over early. The same shot again.
So
3-6-10 on the right-hand lane, and
evidently he figured it was a bad shot the last time, maybe somewhat the lane too.
That's very possible. He did not make the adjustment he thought, as you said, made a bad delivery in the first frame, decided to stay in the same place, a little more projection. Ball still hooked early. Now another good spare.
Bob Loren was sparing the third frame. If he strikes here in the fourth frame, he's going to trail by 30.
And who would have thought that after four frames, the only string of strikes would be Amleto?
Bob Loren with a strike in the fourth frame. We're going to take a break now. As we go, Monticelli in command. Will he stay that way? Well, we don't know. We'll find out more about it when we come back. Stay with us.
Some say winning isn't everything. Some say losing builds character. Some say it's not whether you win or lose, but how you play the game. Some say statements like these were made up by people who don't use ebonite equipment.
Rescue 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Come on, Brian, and rescue me.
The championship round finals of the Ebonite Challenge are being brought to you by Ebonite. With Ebonite, you bowl to win. Be sure to visit our website at www.ebonite.com.
Take a look at this pin action from Bob Loren, and that was high flush and nice, but, you know, after four frames, it's hard to say it's too late, but it's getting later all the time.
Well, right now, they're just praying that Amleto slows down there.
And here we go again, coming out of commercial. We'll see what that layoff has done to Amleto. He hasn't thrown a shot in probably close to 4 or 5 minutes. He knows what to do on lane four. It's just a matter of execution for Amleto Monticelli. And that brings Bob Loren very much back into the situation. Take a look at this ball. It goes to the right, but it goes too far and does not make the turn early enough. Mike, that's a 2-8-10, and we didn't see much of that in practice here, but boy, we saw a lot of it over at Western Branch.
Going for the two, has it. So an open frame in the fifth frame for Amleto Monticelli, reducing his lead of 30 pins down to under 15.
Well, it'll be 15 pins. You know, we bowled the entire week at AMF Western Branch, and it was a very tough condition, and it looks as if the pattern that they put out here on the arena pairs are kind of going toward that tough condition that we bowled on.
Well, they
all
told
week.
Me, they told me they were going to do them the same. Lane three presenting no problem for the players.
Well, Amleto has let everybody back into the match, but Walter definitely needs to strike. He's moved in. A lot of swing. And you can see that Walter Ray Williams Jr. has not given up, even though he's off to a terrible start. Watch this ball, how far it goes to the right. People think Walter just throws the ball straight. I don't think so. Look at that.
Well, double here, put it back within shouting range anyway.
As you can see, Walter loves that reaction. Must have this strike here on lane three. That's got a hook. And who would have thought Walter Ray Williams would throw a ball into the channel?
Gotta have that one.
You know, you've got to like his attitude. My gosh, if that was a Marshall Holman of a few years ago, I don't think I would have been smiling.
Well, he seems to smile no matter what happens.
Yeah! Now, Walter may be going for an all-time low game on television
for himself.
For him, yeah. But I don't think, even with this poor performance today, don't be surprised to see him next Wednesday night.
I think Bob Lurd's going the other way. I think he's going to go straighter, try and go straighter here on lane four.
He moved his feet a little further to the right. He can throw the ball extraordinarily hard. Trying to force the ball into the pocket with speed. Oh, my gosh. Look at that 10-pin.
Did it a couple of times, but didn't knock it over.
And Bob Lurd kind of gives a little bit of a sarcastic thank you, and I don't blame him. Watch this pin action, Mike. Look at the head pin. Go to the sideboard. Oh, it's coming back. It's got enough force. Just not quite enough to knock it over.
I asked Bob Lurd about how he or what method he uses to control his speed.
I'm a leg bowler, so I can control my speed through my leg speed. So if I want to throw it harder, I move back on the approach, and I increase my speed going to the line.
Asking for a re-rack on lane three, and that's the method he basically used on lane four, almost a good success.
Boy, I made a great shot. If anything, possibly, he's, you know, for a right-hander, we look at the 1-3. Those are the key pins. We want to make sure they're not too far apart, or if they're too close.
And we
take a look. Excuse me, Mike. We take a look at the finalists by round, and Monticelli was in the lead at the start of the tournament, ended up third. Hoskins, he came from off the pace of the first round, but most of the players were pretty much up there all the way.
And Lurd went around Monticelli the last ball by a pin. So.
Is it?
So he's asking, I think, if it's on second ball. That's what he's worried, that it's on second ball.
Well, this is where a pro really has to regroup his concentration right now. Bob Lurd was ready to throw the shot. Had to put the ball down. Did he regroup himself?
Nope.
No, he did not. That's a shame. And right now, Amleto Monticelli finds himself...
Way to clear my mind.
Very good shape again, as he says. He didn't, really didn't clear his mind. He
cleared my mind.
3-6-7-10, makeable split.
A very makeable split. He'll throw the ball hard and straight. He's made the 3-6-10 twice on the right-hand lane, lane four. It's basically the same thing. Just need to get the ball to the right of the three pin, throw it into the seven.
So Amleto in a commanding position, leading by 30 pins over Bob Lurd and overwhelming 65 pins on Walter Ray.
Oh, solid nine for Amleto. Well, that really would have been the final nail, probably, if he would have got that one. Keeps a little bit of life open for at least Bob Lurd.
30 pins, still the difference there. Four frames to go, so Lurd's still alive. But Amleto back solid in the 1-3 pocket.
Yeah, he's, you know, and Amleto's the type of player that even though he got a bad break, he's going to pat himself on the back for making a good shot. He makes the spare.
Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, plays host to the final event of the Senior PGA Tour. That's the Senior Tour Championship. ESPN's coverage begins tomorrow at 2 p.m., continues through Sunday as the top seniors compete for the prize in the Energizer Senior Tour Championship. Hale Irvin just seems to win everything out there.
Well, he's got one more chance to get the, is it the 10th win he's going for this year or the 11th? I've kind of lost
track.
I
can't count that high, so I just know he's made well over $2 million in prize money.
He's done just fine.
Amleto, 8th frame, lane 3. Leading by 30.
Continue to keep the pressure on. No problem on that lane.
You see Walter give him a little five there?
I certainly did. You know, Walter is... If you can find something bad to say about Walter Ray Williams, I'm not really sure what it would be. He really is quite a gentleman when he's out on the lanes. now, Walter Ray, if he were to strike out, he'd shoot 190. That's Steve Hoskins' little girl, Lindsay. She's getting ready to watch Daddy Bull next.
Yeah, he's coming up pretty quick, and he was hitting him in practice very well, too.
He looked pretty strong. Well, and a solid 10 for Walter Ray Williams. And that is the end of his chances of moving on.
He still has a chance, though, for the challenge, the Ebonite Challenge, even finishing fourth.
Yes, he does. Amleto Monacelli would have to win the tournament in order to knock Walter Ray out of the Ebonite Challenge, which we'll have as our final match this evening.
And if Bob Learn wants any kind of chance in this match, you better start striking him right now.
Come on. Come on. Hold it. Yeah.
Mike, he's got a chance to shoot 225 if he takes it off the sheet. Right now, Amleto Monacelli working at a 215 pace. If he spares strikes, a case can be made for Bob Learn still being in this match.
Down 30. Strike here cuts it to 20.
Learn's used to throwing strikes in arena formats.
Hold on. Oh, come on.
No,
that was not a bad shot.
Well, I disagree.
That was not a bad shot. All right.
I disagree with that, Bob. I really think when he lets go of the ball, he's a little short and left to his target. I just don't think that ball ever got far enough to the right of the lane. Maybe he felt he hit his target, but I don't think so.
Amleto, total command of our opening match. It looks like he'll be moving on to face Hoskins. We'll find out when we come back after this.
This month, everyone can watch a hit for only $3.95. Check out the variety of movies you can see conveniently in your own home theater. With pay-per-view, the hits are delivered right to your home, hassle-free, instantly. No tapes to return, no late fees to worry about. And everyone can watch for one low price, only $3.95. Just pick your flick, place your order, and before you know it, you'll be enjoying the movie of your choice in your own home theater. Everyone can do it, so this month, pay-per-view it.
To commemorate the opening coin toss ceremony, the National Football League commissioned Environment to create the official game coin for the Philadelphia Eagles. And now you can reserve one of these historic Philadelphia Eagles game coins for only $59.95. A limited edition of 7,500 game coins will be minted, and each is individually numbered with a certificate of authenticity. The coin is minted with 1 troy ounce of pure silver. And if you call right now, you'll receive this collector's display case absolutely free. Reserve your official Eagles game coin. Call 1-800-257-5700.
And we're in beautiful Virginia Beach. It was a gorgeous day down here today. A little bit chilly, but you can see the beautiful scenery and lots of boats, lots of water, lots of blue sky.
Beautiful day, Mike. Just a tad a bit of wind, but my gosh, it's November. Amleto leading by 42 pins, and he's really can just put it totally out of reach with a strike here. That's it. And he knows it.
Well, he's never really challenged.
No, a unbelievably easy run for Amleto Monacelli. I thought it was going to be a 250 game, a 240 game, a 230 game, but
sometimes the bowlers practice too long.
Well, yeah, and they can take that oil and shove it down the lane, get that carry down and make the lanes a little more difficult at times. Just need to keep it on the lane. Yeah, that stayed on the lane, Amleto. You're okay. He'll be in the 220s with a conversion, and there's nothing Walter Ray Williams Jr. can do, and there's nothing Bob Learn Jr. can do. So a little bit of tough goes for the juniors.
Maybe if we added their scores together.
Yeah, they got them.
Amleto just finishing it out with Phil, Tim Pim Phil. He'll finish with 224. Keep himself sharp for the next game against Steve Hoskins. Well, lots of excitement, very little drama, but lots of excitement. A very enthusiastic crowd hoping for a better match in the championship match.
Yeah, Walter Ray just finishing out the string, and boy, for yeah, you can see Walter's getting ready to go home and kick the dog.
I wonder if this is his low game of all time on TV.
Well, boy, it could be.
Now, Marshall, are you speaking from experience there?
Why would? Well, there have been times when I was upset after a telecast, but the dog was always in no trouble.
Or whatever I'm gonna shoot.
All right, the PBA is online for all the information you need on the Professional Bowlers Tour. Check out the PBA website. The new address is www.pbatour.com. Dial in that for all the information and latest stats on the PBA Tour. That's www.pbatour.com.
And with a spare and a strike, Walter Ray can do no better than 148. And he'll finish in fourth position. That'll be another little $7,000 check to put into his bank account, which is... That'll be pretty nice if that is his lowest game on television.
Well, it was his low game this week was 174. I don't know about his low game on TV.
I would...
I would venture to say it's got to be pretty close.
I would venture to say it is. Bob Learn keeping a pretty good attitude also. And Walter Ray and Bob Learn give each other five. Well, in just another couple of minutes, we'll have a lot of time to talk about this game as they are relegated to innocent bystanders.
Well, Walter still has a chance to bowl another game. He's rooting for Steve Hoskins right now.
That is true.
Regardless of what Learn bowled in this game, even if Walter would have beaten him, the lowest that he could have finished by PBA rules is one spot below where he qualified, which was second, so the lowest he could have finished was third. He's going to wind up there anyway by his score.
Bob Learn, third place, 9,000. Walter Ray, fourth place, 7,000. Amleto Monticelli going for the title.
As we see, Walter Ray at 70. He's probably averaging about that a week. No, he's probably doing better than that a week. 7,000?
Yeah, well, Walter is just making a steady climb, looking to go to 3 million, I'm sure. And the way he makes it every year, it shouldn't take him very long.
Bob Lord finishes with 193. The winner, Amleto Monticelli. When we come back, amidst all this excitement, we'll talk about the other finishers. Stay with us.
No two bowling centers are the same. Conditions vary, even from approach to approach. That's why Dexter invented the SST5 bowling shoe. It has a patented system of interchangeable soles and soles with 16 possible combinations in all. Each is anchored in position with a sturdy Velcro base. So no matter what your style of play, you'll find sure footing on just about any surface imaginable. It's only a little scratch.
Here a scratch, there a scratch, everywhere a scratch, scratch. And they're all an eyesore. What you need is GS27 Scratch Remover. It's new from Duralube. GS27 gets rid of those surface scratches and paint swirls quickly and easily. Simply rub it into the scratch, then polish to a beautiful finish. The scratch is gone. GS27 is not an abrasive, and it works wonders on any color. Would you do this to a brand new car? Ouch! But GS27 removes that ugly scratch quickly and easily. It'll even remove paint scrapes and unsightly rust. GS27 is only $14.95, but order now and get a second tube for only $5. That's two for just $19.95. Order now.
Call 1-800-313-1900 or send check or money order for $14.95 for one or $19.95 for two, plus $5.95 shipping to GS27, 1000 Apex Street, Department GS, Nashville, Tennessee.
Mark Hayes came to Bristol specifically to study under Dean Berman, whose forte is football rhetoric.
Drew Bledsoe, nickname, who wants a crack at it?
Drew bled so much that he needed a transfusion.
Boring. Ms. Allen.
It's a trick question. Drew Bledsoe has no nickname.
Students are taught not just how to ask questions, but more importantly, how to ask questions about football.
Maybe a stupid question, but I...
There is no such thing as a stupid question, Mr. Hayes. Just stupid people that ask questions. Yes.
Does dysentery rhyme with singletary?
Now let's take a look at the top finishers for this week's Ebonite Challenge. In sixth place, shooting a 300 game in the position round, Tommy DeLutz Jr. And our heart goes out to Doug Kent. After 42 games, he missed the telecast by just one pin and sat there for about 20 minutes before he got himself together to go back to the locker room.
Tim Criss, another solid tournament for him as he finishes in the top 24 for the 20th time this year.
Smooth stroking Brian Goebel. He's one of two Ebonite Pro Staff members to make match play this week.
And a powerful up-and-coming star from the Great Northwest, Len Blakey.
And he goes where his motorhome takes him, Wayne Webb. He's won twice this year, having a resurgence in his career. The winner in match number one, Amleto Monacelli. He bowled 224. We won't tell you what Walter Way bowled or Bob learned. That earns him the right to move on to take on Steve Hoskins for the title. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Recently it was asked, is bowling really a sport? Does it really take persistence and endurance to knock down a few little pins? Is bowling even worthy of coverage on national TV? We know the answers to questions like these. And some people, they just wouldn't understand.
One name that's always on the job, Arrow. The Arrow T50 staple gun for insulation and 1,001 household uses. The hot melt glue gun with automatic lever feed for home repairs and arts and crafts. T50 staple gun, hot melt glue gun. Arrow, you'll grow attached.
Before I quit smoking, I asked my doctor, is Nicorette gum safe? And he said, to quit smoking? Of course Nicorette gum is safe. Smoking is not. People smoke to get nicotine, and they get carbon monoxide and tars, which are deadly. Smoking is the danger. Nicorette can be a big part of the solution. Nicorette lets you use nicotine when you need it to help you overcome your cravings. Don't hesitate for a second.
Commit to quit for the Great American Smokeout on November 20th. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
Brooks Brothers' latest eyewear. Tailored in about an hour. At LensCrafters. The Brooks Brothers event. On now at LensCrafters.
Great shot here at the pavilion, Virginia Beach. Steve Hoskins, who bowled that fantastic 300 game a few weeks ago in Rochester. Both these guys have won already this fall, Marshall.
And they're both power players. You like to see the ball hook? Take a look at strong 5'5" Steve Hoskins. And something got him. Somehow the machine on lane one re-racked. Now, if I was Steve, I would put the ball down. He's got somebody moving on his left. He's got the machine re-racking in front of him.
Well, he hasn't thrown it yet, Marsh. He just needs to regroup. It's the first frame. Somebody else moving over there now, too.
Well, he makes a good shot, and these people, they just don't understand how there's like a little revolving door to our left. People going in, people coming out.
Headed to the men's room or somewhere. Cross lane at the four pin with a straight ball. Actually goes down the left side of the lane. Is that the way you shoot that, or do you go cross lane?
Well, I prefer to go cross lane, but Steve likes going straight down the left, and it works well with him, and we still have people moving all over the place. It's a big arena. There's a lot of people in here.
And Leto, lane four.
You know, Mike, both of these gentlemen have won on this fall swing. Steve Hoskins in Rochester, where he shot that great 300 game in the semifinal match. And Amleto Monticelli just a couple weeks ago in Bay City,
where he was the only right-hander on the telecast that day.
Yeah, and it certainly worked to his advantage.
Amleto trying for a quick 10-pin lead.
Got a hook. Look at that ball get back. I thought that was going to be light, Mike. But Amleto snapped it right back into the pocket.
Well, it was light, but it was a light strike.
Yeah, take a look at this shot. It hit 17 at the arrows. Now it's on two. Now they're all gone.
Well, that's Amleto. It's Steve Hoskins, too. That's he's deeper.
They both have that ability. We'll see where Steve's ball is rolling over the arrows. His ball got to about 18.
Now it's time for Dexter Footwork of the Pros.
We take a look at Steve Hoskins. Very much a heel toe in his first step. Then he starts developing a little more speed and a big leg drive for all that power. Nice perpendicular with the foul line. You don't see a lot of bowlers do that, but Steve has very good form at the line.
And Leto is perpendicular at the foul line also.
Always thought it was very important, but a lot of players get away with not doing that. Come on. How about the fire from Steve Hoskins?
Whoa. It's interesting. I don't think Amleto has seen any of these people move at all. He is so into it.
Amleto Monticelli on the right side and Mike Albee on the left side, I think, are the two best as far as mentally handling their game. There's three in a row, and that ball looked like it was high. And okay, Mike, you're right. It was high. High flush.
Kind of crunched the four pin right there.
Wow.
Paul Stankowski will be on hand to defend his title as the PGA heads to Hawaii for the Lincoln Murky Kapalua International. ESPN's coverage begins tomorrow, 4 o'clock. It continues through Saturday. For four in a row.
Well, I'd be interested to see that shot again. Was that in his release? Was it his speed? I'm not really certain, but Amleto knows he didn't make a good shot. Now he'll take another ball. We'll take a look at this and see if it gets far enough to the right. And that was about a board and a half left of his target. And he does not convert. Take a look at the way Amleto snaps through this release. Bang, like starting a lawnmower.
Amazing. Suddenly now Amleto is trailing in this match by 7 pins and can go down more.
You'll see some fire if he strikes here. No, it's a flat 10.
Big, big match for Amleto, because if he wins this match, he's in the Ebonite Challenge against Jason Couch and Steve Hoskins. Hoskins is there no matter what.
Hoskins is already qualified, as Jason Couch has. Now we take a look at Lisa, his wife, and Lindsay, his lovely little daughter. And Lisa's going, okay, now be quiet, Mom.
So we see that qualify for the Ebonite Challenge. Players are awarded points based on where they finished in the top 24. And they're awarded through the first 5 tournaments of the fall. This is the 5th tournament.
Yeah, the top 3 point leaders qualify for that $10,000 winner-take-all match. Steve Hoskins on the left-hand lane. It's got to hurry. And look at that ball get back. And I think he thinks he might have got away with one there.
Well, I think he heard a noise. It was like a big sound in the background.
Another distraction. And you're right. You know, Amleto doesn't seem to hear these noises. I would hear them.
Well, some people can Amleto, shut these things out.
If Amleto wins this match, he's in the Ebonite Challenge. If he does not win it, we're going to see Walter Ray Williams Jr. again and see if he can chew better than 148.
Amleto saying, Walter, I love you, but I don't want you bowling.
Amleto down by 6 pins now. He goes back to lane 3. That's the lane that he left that 6-7-10 on in the fourth frame.
For the lead, 6th frame, our championship match. The championship match, Amleto leading by 6 pins. Can Hoskins come back? Well, we think he'll make a run, and we'll find out right after this. You stay with us.
Recently it was asked, is bowling really a sport? Does it really take persistence and endurance to knock down a few little pins? Is bowling even worthy of coverage on national TV? We know the answers to questions like these. And some people, they just wouldn't understand.
Let's see. It says here you're, lazy.
Highly unmotivated. You have a problem with authority.
Yeah, I've got two references to prove that.
Well, the only thing I can say is... You da man! You da man!
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Technically, I can't give you a raise yet.
You're right, policy, schmaltzy.
See, that is a picture of the Depression. And yet, what I've done is colorize that picture, and it's not as depressing. Voila! Depressing? Not depressing. You can almost imagine the look on their faces. They're a little happier. Pop's got a red plaid shirt and a blue jumper.
An enthusiastic crowd here in Virginia Beach at the Pavilion. PBA Tour has not been to this part of the country since 1969. I remember I bowled in that tournament, Marshall. Made the 7-10. That was the only time I ever made it.
Happy to say I was still in high school. That's got a really hook.
Oh, my goodness.
There's a trouble shot.
Out of the commercial break?
Yeah.
Now, you know, I bowled next to Pete Weber this week. And he left this several times and made it two or three times at least by hitting that two on the left side, you know, and just sliding it right across, hitting it real thin.
It can be made. It's a difficult shot. It helps if you hook the ball, and Steve Hoskins does. So he has that going for him and really needs to make this stay in touch. Come on. It didn't quite hook far enough to the left. Now we'll take a look at how he left this. You can see the ball starting very deep. That was at 18 at the arrows. Now it's all the way to 1, and it just cannot recover enough to hook back and get into the 1-3 pocket. Coming in so far behind the head pin, that's why you leave the 2-4-8 and that 10 pin.
Now he's 18 pins behind. Scoreboard tells the story right there.
He makes a good shot. The 6-pin leans on the 10-pin, but it doesn't fall. And right now, Amleto Monticelli is in a very, very solid position, working on a double as Steve Hoskins attempts to make this 10-pin and keep it an 18-pin match.
He does exactly that, but the look on his face tells the story right now. Monticelli steps up in the 7th frame, leading by 18 with... The axe ready to guillotine him.
Well, yeah, he's really got a very, very good situation right now. If he strikes, takes a 28-pin lead, it's tough to catch Amleto when he's a front-running kind of a player that he is. Well, he didn't strike, and boy, did he get a great break.
That could have been 6.
That could have easily been, you know, the big five or the big four.
As it is, it's just the seven pin.
Take a look at this shot. It's going to, the break point is much earlier, never gets far enough to the right. I just don't know how that ball didn't split as much as it was hooking into the pocket.
Converts the seven pin in the seventh frame, leading by 17 pins. And we see the all-time money leaders there. Amleto closing in on $1,600,000 in sixth place of all time. There's the scoreboard. 17 pins can be made up in three frames. Anything can still happen. Marticelli with a strike in the eighth frame.
Well, his house is rocking now. They're rocking and stomping.
Hoskins.
Hoskins down by 17. Eight. Striking the eighth and ninth can make it a seven-pin match. Really needs it.
Perfect. I asked him if his 300 game and win in Rochester raised his confidence level to a new level.
It's been kind of an up-and-down year for me after breaking my hand, and I think Rochester just cemented any kind of doubt that I might have had earlier in the year. And it's allowed me just to relax and bowl my game.
Well, right now his game is hooking the ball, power, and he needs it in the ninth frame.
Monticelli working on a 212 pace. Hoskins with the opportunity for 225 if he strikes in the ninth and strikes out in the tenth. This to take it to a seven-pin lead. Monticelli now only seven pins ahead, and we've got ourselves a match, Mike.
Does Amleto move deeper on this right lane?
Well, that's the. I would think that he's got to make some type of a move. As we take a look at this pin action from Steve Hoskins, it was just dead flush and perfect. Every pin took care of itself. Look how excited he is. The problem with Amleto's last shot is he didn't get it far enough down the lane. Much better this time. Much better shot, but he leaves the 10 pin, and now Hoskins has the opportunity to control his own destiny.
Best Amleto can get if he makes this and strikes out is 222.
Amleto still ahead.
Has the spare.
He makes the spare. Amleto cannot shut Steve Hoskins out. The best he can do, once again, will be 222. Steve Hoskins has a chance for 225. Amleto, let it rip. Well, he does that, Mike.
Yeah, I have no doubt that he'll do that in the 10th frame here.
He struck the last two times on this lane.
He's looking for the score. What's the situation? He's looking for the score.
He wants to know what he needs, and boy, I don't blame him right now. This big building, he's looking for a scorekeeper.
These guys can keep scoring their head, but sometimes you lose a little bit of track.
Yeah, if he strikes here, he's going to put Steve Hoskins in the same situation he was in Rochester. Two strikes to win a tournament. Oh, what a great break. He just sort of tickled him over that time, Mike. And this house is really rocking again, but they're doing the Amleto stomp.
I thought it was the Macarena. A strike makes it 222, makes Hoskins get two strikes and eight to win.
Yeah, very reminiscent of what he did in Rochester just a couple of weeks ago. Blows a kiss to the crowd, and he says, okay, Steve, here you go.
Steve Hoskins asked for a re-rack in the 10th frame. The graphic shows And he needs two strikes and eight pins. And, of course, the only way you can approach that is one at a time. If he doesn't strike, Amleto wins 25 with a chance to make 10 more.
Well, Steve, you did it a couple of weeks ago in Rochester. Can you do it again? What a great shot, and his wife is just going crazy over there. Lisa is happy. And there's Lindsay. Attaboy, Daddy. Well, Mike, he did it in Rochester. He shot 300 in Rochester.
You predicted that.
Well, he seems to be becoming one of the great clutch players. He needs to strike an eight. I think he does it.
Right now, I wouldn't bet against him.
He's taking a little extra time, Mike. He threw the shot good. It wasn't to be. They're very good friends, Mike. And very good friends. And little Monticelli, he's your winner. And Lisa, she's proud of her man. If he throws a great shot, a little extra loft.
And
it's coming back. Just doesn't quite get it. Oh, there's Lisa. That's Steve's wife. Come on, baby.
Amleto, passive until he sees the result.
All he can say is thank you.
Amleto Monticelli has won his second tournament of the fall. He's qualified for the Ebonite Challenge. Now, when we come back, right after these messages, we're going to talk to Amleto. We're going to give him a check and a trophy and have a little drawing. So you stay with us. We'll be back after this.
Evander Holyfield beat Mike Tyson. Then he beat him again. He beat Foreman and Bo, too. He beat everybody. Everybody except IBF champion Michael Moore. Holyfield, Moore, 2. World Heavyweight Championship. One of four championship fights Saturday, November 8th. Sponsored by Budweiser. Live on pay-per-view from the Mirage. Evander, you beat everybody. Except...
Well, if I had money, I'd tell you what to do. I'd go downtown, buy a Ford truck or two. I'm crazy about a Ford truck.
There's 50 years of toughness built into every new 98 F-150. That's why Ford F-Series continues to be America's best-selling truck. And right now, $198 a month gets you into a new F-150. That's just $198 a month for 24 months. And you'll be driving away with more standard horsepower and more payload than any other full-size pickup on the road. See your Quality Plus Ford dealer today.
Come on, folks. No, why don't you get over here? Talk to me, guys. All right, we're a little late getting out here, Amleto, but you weren't late with that strike.
Well, this was really an exciting match, especially the last one against my very good friend Steve Hoskins. Both of us really always dreamed to ball each other, and we really didn't care who was going to win. I mean, of course you want to win, but we're really good friends, so I just want to say that Steve, you ball great all week. So,
well, right now we've got a presentation for you. Gary Beck, right to your left here, the tournament chairperson, has a gorgeous trophy for you.
Amleto, on behalf of Killer Bee Promotions and the outstanding bowling fans here in Hampton Roads, want to present this trophy to you as the first champion of the Ebonite Challenge Tournament in Virginia Beach. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'd like to say thank you to Ebonite, who sponsored this tournament, and I also want to thank my sponsor track for this beautiful ball. And I want to say hi to my wife. Kisses. She's in Miami right now, and I'm going to see her tomorrow.
Well, right now you're going to say hi to Bill Scheid, the president of Ebonite International, who's got a big, big check for you.
M. Leto, on behalf of Ebonite, congratulations. It was a great victory. You're a real champion.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. I want to say thank you to you guys that came here to watch us today. Thank you for coming.
Well, right now, we're not done yet because the PBA is a proud sponsor of the American Scholarship Tournament. And we're going to do the American Scholarship Sweepstakes right now. And you get the honor of doing that. So we've got a basket or a box right here. You're going to draw a name out of that. The winner of that name that you draw is going to have a vacation for four at Orlando. And it's also going to win $500 for a scholarship. That'll be SeaWorld of Orlando and a $500 scholarship courtesy of PNC Bank. So draw it out there. And the winner is Nick Ellis of Norwalk, Ohio, a Buckeye.
Congratulations down there. I know you're watching.
Well, congratulations on behalf of ESPN. And you folks out there, don't go away because we're going to be back with the Ebonite Sweepstakes and see who wins that Ford F-150 truck. Right after this, stay with us.
Make sure the sports fan on your gift list enjoys the holidays in championship style with Sports Illustrated's amazing holiday gift pack. Call this toll-free number now to stuff their stocking with Give Me Five, the thrilling new video featuring the best of all five Bulls NBA championships. Plus, this exclusive Sports Illustrated basketball sweatshirt. Both this great-looking sweatshirt and the Bulls video are free with your paid gift subscription to Sports Illustrated, the best way to light up a sports fan every week. Your gift video puts him courtside with the champion Bulls so he can relive those marvelous memories from championships past. To treasure forever the greatness of those teams.
This is the greatest performance maybe ever.
And their unforgettable heroics.
Third in a row, they are now the Pitbulls. Bulls.
Give your favorite fan the thrills he wants. The best of the Bulls' five NBA championships. Plus, this authentic Sports Illustrated basketball sweatshirt. It's extra large and extra special with a logo that shows what he likes. This is the sweatshirt he wants. And with Sports Illustrated, he'll receive an exciting new gift every week, all year long. This fine card will announce your gifts. Both great gifts are free with your order of 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.48 an issue. Save over 57% off the cover price. Use your credit card to get this special bonus, a limited edition five-time champion sports watch. It's the commemorative sports watch that just keeps on winning. Don't let them miss a memory.
Let the party begin.
One phone call brings them an unforgettable holiday gift pack. The great Bulls video, the SI basketball sweatshirt, and the Bulls sports watch, all three free from Sports Illustrated. Call now to make sure they get the best. Give Sports Illustrated. It's what they want.
It's ESPN's Sunday Night NFL. This week, Cordell Stewart and the Pittsburgh Steelers play host to Vinny Testaverde and the Baltimore Ravens in an AFC Central clash. Ravens Steelers, Sunday at 8, only on ESPN.
Welcome back to the Virginia Beach Pavilion in the final Ebonite Challenge Sweepstakes, where someone will win a Ford F-150 pickup truck. Last night at Pin Boys at Western Branch, an amateur bowler's name was chosen. And in a moment, he will have a chance to throw a strike. But before he gets a chance to throw the ball, he will draw a pen pal from entries throughout the country. If he strikes, then both of them will have a chance for the Ford truck. If he does not strike, a drawing will be held after the shot from the entries throughout the country, and somebody will definitely win that truck. And now, let's go down to Marshall Holman and tonight's contestant for the final Ebonite Challenge Sweepstakes.
Thank you very much, Mike. I'm with Brian Carroll from Chesapeake, Virginia, and congratulations for making it this far.
Thank you.
All right, now our first order of business. Let's pick out a pin pal out of the ticket mixer. All right. Shauna Glenn from Lewiston, Texas, and it was the Lewiston, Texas Pro Shop. Shauna, right now I'd be rooting for Brian to get a strike here. Now, Brian, you do bowl.
Yes, sir.
You're a league bowler.
Yes, sir.
And have you had any good averages, good games?
I've rolled a 300 before.
All right. Well, that's what we like here. You rolled a 300. All right. Well, you've got a brand new Ebonite Werewolf ball. You got the good-looking shirt on. Go up there and give it your best shot. Remember, if you strike, you have a no worse than 1 in 2 chance to win that 1998 Ford F-150 pickup truck, and we're all rooting for you. Make a good shot. And they're rooting for you, too. Getting a big hug from his dad. We have Bill Scheid, the president of Ebonite International, joining us. All right, Brian, come on over here to my right. Now, this is a rather important moment for you. You have to pick one of these two envelopes. One has your name in it, and one has your pen pal's name in it. So, go ahead. You make the call. All right. Tell you what, you open it up, and then hand me that name. Now don't peek. I'm sorry, it's the pen pal. Oh, Brian. Oh, that's too bad. Well, Shauna Glenn, she's our winner. Thank you very much, Bill, and Mike, back up to you.
Brian Carroll is disappointed, but we've got Shauna Glenn from Dallas on the phone. Shauna, can you hear us? Shauna, do you hear us? This is Mike Durbin from ESPN.
Yeah, I can hear y'all.
Wonderful. Are you excited?
I cannot believe this.
You can't believe it. Have you ever won anything before in a drawing or anything?
No, I haven't.
Do you have a driver's license?
Yes, I sure do.
So, are you planning on driving this Ford F-150 truck?
Yes, I do.
Oh, well, we want to offer our congratulations to you, and I'm sure that you have a special thanks for Brian as he got that strike and chose your name. Congratulations, Shauna.
Thank you.
After this will be the Ebonite Challenge. Three players, Couch, Monticelli, Hoskins, going for 10,000. Winner take all. Stay tuned. We'll see who wins.
No two bowling centers are the same. Conditions vary, even from approach to approach. That's why Dexter invented the SST5 bowling shoe. It has a patented system of interchangeable heels and soles with 16 possible combinations in all. Each is anchored in position with a sturdy Velcro base. So no matter what your style of play, you'll find sure footing on just about any surface imaginable.
Payday. Payday after taxes. Sweet caramel, salty peanuts. It's payday.
One name that's always on the job, Arrow. The Arrow T50 staple gun for insulation and 1,001 household uses. The hot melt glue gun with automatic lever feed for home repairs and arts and crafts. T50 staple gun, hot melt glue gun. Arrow, you'll grow attached.
Hoskins will start the match. He was the top seed and he can choose where he wants to go. He wants to get his score on the board first.
And this game is going to fly by, Mike. We're going to speed up the action a little bit. After Hoskins bowls, after this shot by Hoskins, if he strikes, the second bowler will get up. There, Hoskins sticks his tongue out at that one. That's the lane that cost him the tournament.
Yeah, he wanted to strike one time before.
Yeah, he was having a little fun with that lane.
Hoskins, again, with an opportunity to jump out to a quick 10-pin lead over both Monticelli and Couch. Steve is only 28 years of age as he sends it in there and gets a left tap.
And he gets the 10. Well, here comes Amleto. I wonder if he has any gas left after winning that last match to win the title.
I'm sure he does.
Yeah, I would think so. Amleto is in great, great physical condition. He runs, he works out, he watches Amleto. What he eats.
He says that 10,000 will buy a lot of gas. He can recover later.
Yeah, he's going to be just fine. You know what I'm interested to see is how is the lanes going to be for Jason Couch? We've had nothing but right-handers bowling the entire telecast. Now he gets what I consider to be a fairly fresh side of the lane to bowl on. Will that be an advantage?
We'll find out quickly.
That's right. We'll see what his ball looks like.
Amleto wants to stay pace with Hoskins with a strike here on lane three, the lane that he struck out to win the tournament.
All right, the people love him. Yeah, we've had four shots thrown, we've had four strikes, and our first look at another bowler who really likes to hook it.
Wow, a little fire from him too.
He's been watching these other guys getting all excited all night. Says now it's my turn.
Well, right now we've had five shots, five strikes. He's waiting for the ball to come back. Here it comes. Jason Couch, who led the tournament in Bay City, the Mobile One Classic, and only bowled 191, lost Amleto in that tournament.
And it was a tough defeat for him because he really dominated the entire tournament.
Be sure to be with us next week from Hammerville, Pennsylvania. It's the Bayer Brunswick Touring Players Championship. That's next Wednesday night, 7:30 Eastern Time. Always a great tournament.
Well, he moved it, but he did not quite get the seven pin to fall. Taking very little time, switching balls.
At the seven pin, cross. Well, he goes down the left side of the
lane. Down the left side, hard and straight.
Vice President of Sales for Ebonite International, Bill Supper. Enjoying Ebonite's relationship with the Professional Bowlers Association this fall.
Been a good friend of bowling for a long, long time. I've known Billy for pretty much all my career.
Very good bowler in his own right.
Yes.
So it's the third frame. Hoskins gets the first spare of the match.
Well, he got all that one, as we say. And there's the commissioner of the PBA, Mark Gerbrick, enjoying the action. And good to see him out here.
Amleto taking a re-rack on lane four. Can take the lead in the match with a strike here.
You see Amleto very consistent over the year.
Oh, very consistent tonight.
Beautiful shot. There's the president of Ebonite International, Mr. Bill Scheid, and he's smiling. He likes seeing those strikes.
And I think he likes Ebonite's relationship with the Professional Bowlers Association this year also. And Leto up by 11 over Hoskins, 10 over Couch. Can increase it 10 more with another strike.
Yeah, Mike, he looks real tired to me.
I don't know. Where's he getting that gas from? Couch can stay pace with a couple of strikes. Looked like it was going to be solid, just snapped right at
the
end, Marshall.
That ball really, really is hooking very, very hard.
At the four
pin. He'll throw it very hard and straight. No, actually even hooks it a little bit.
Now it's time for Dexter, footwork of the pros.
As we take a look at Jason Couch, a little bit of shuffle step on the first step. and a nice slide. Gets there a little bit early, a little bit on his toes. But overall, very, very good.
Hoskins up looking at the rack on lane four, already asking for a re-rack over there. Both players, Hoskins and Couch, trailing by 11.
Has it.
Down by 21, both players, I should say. Can they come back? Well, we think they can. We'll come back right after these messages.
Here's my idea. I think Best Buy ought to get me in a Rolling Stones concert.
Rolling Stones!
We're here.
I need to know where my seat is.
Front row, man.
Front row seat to the Stones. Now that's a great idea. Get the Rolling Stones Bridges to Babylon at Best Buy.
Are you tired of playing Twister with messy rope, tape, and twist ties? Then you need the Handy Bundler, the world's first endless tie wrap dispenser. No matter what the size, Handy Bundler tightens to a perfect fit every time and secures anything as easy as one, two, three. Now neatly wrap cable and TV wires for a better appearance. Tie garbage bags tight in seconds. Look, ordinary tie wraps just aren't long enough, but the Handy Bundler's cord extends to any size, large or small, it wraps them all. You'll find hundreds of uses for the Handy Bundler around the shop, at home, in the office, and on the job. You get the Handy Bundler, over 50 feet of durable nylon strapping, and 100 locking clips, all for $19.95. And it comes with this unconditional money-back guarantee. Order now.
Call 1-800-994-4554. Or send $19.95 plus $5.95 shipping to the address on your screen. For faster delivery, call 1-800-994-4554.
An important message for investors.
Don't panic if the market drops a few points. Don't run for cover every time some economic indicator hiccups. Don't let short-term thinking influence your long-term investments.
Get Smith Barney's special report, Opportunities in Today's Volatile Markets. Call 1-800-EARNS-IT, extension 70, and discover our predictions for interest rates, inflation, and which stocks we're recommending now. Call today, Smith Barney. They make money the old-fashioned way. They earn it.
Well, while we were away, this is what happened to Amleto after four strikes in a row, Mike. That ball hooked early on him, didn't get it far enough to the right, left a very difficult 3-6-9-10.
And made it.
He made the spare, but right now he trails by three because Steve Hoskins, he struck in the fifth and the sixth frame.
While we were away, this is what Steve Hoskins did. Looks pretty good. Looks just like what he did when he had that 300.
And he goes to the left-hand lane, tries to duplicate the magic. And he does.
And back live, Jason Couch doubles in the fifth frame. So if Jason strikes here, all three players will be in the 220s. And Amleto will be trailing the other two by four pins. So where we had no drama in the opening match with three bowling at the same time.
This is what we expected earlier. Well, we're getting it now. Jason's 15th career TV appearance. 7 wins, 10 losses. Pretty good average, but he'd like to make it 8-10. And that is as good as he can throw it. He's walking back with so much confidence. And there's Jason's wife, Kelly.
Scoreboard tells the story right there. Hoskins and Couch even. Monticelli trailing by four. We head to the seventh frame.
He thought he had it.
And the seven pin again. That's two of them in this game. One in the third frame, now one in the seventh.
Yeah. He wheeled that ball. He trusted it. That's his shot. That's the way he likes to throw the ball. It came back, but did not take care of the seventh. Now the spare ball does.
Going dead straight at it. He heads to the left lane. Working on 228 right now. Trying to get a strike up to work on something. Head into the ninth frame. Right now, Couch is in the driver's seat.
Oh, very much so. He's got the string of strikes. He's ahead, albeit only by one against Hoskins.
Wow, did he catch all of that?
There's Steve's son and wife Lisa. That's Ryan. Wave, Ryan. And boy, does he look like his daddy.
Wonder if he'll throw the ball like his daddy. Here's Amleto.
Stop. Bad shot. Bad shot. And take a look at Steve Hoskins. Now watch how far to the right this ball went. Bang, as he really got every ounce of his fingers into that ball.
Amleto, 3-6-10, seventh frame, needs to make it to stay in the match.
Well, he makes it, Mike. But the last time Amleto was on that right-hand lane, it looked like he may have hurt his arm a little bit. He threw the ball, and then he sort of touched his arm where he has it wrapped.
Well, he has a wrap on there, and he says it's from a strained muscle. I asked him about that earlier. It's not tendonitis or anything. It's a strained muscle.
For Amleto on the left lane.
Jason Couch can take the lead in this match with a strike right here.
He's got to be careful on this lane. He's come in high a couple of times. Really needs to project. Well, he can.
Nice. I told him he had a tough loss a couple of weeks ago. Had he recovered?
You know, I have to take it 1 week at a time, Mike, and I just want to redeem myself from a couple of weeks ago. Had a bad outing after leading the tournament by a lot of pins, and tonight my first thought is redemption.
Well, right now, his redemption is up. He's in the 230s right now, leading by 11 pins over Hoskins.
Well, he's thrown a lot of strikes this game, but none better than he has on this left-hand lane. This is a lane he likes.
Jason Cowell. Taking command for the Ebonite Challenge. Will he win it? But we'll find out when we come back after this commercial break. Now don't hit that remote. Stay with us.
Make sure the sports fan on your gift list enjoys the holidays in championship style with Sports Illustrated's amazing holiday gift pack. Call this toll-free number now to stuff their stocking with Give Me Five, the thrilling new video featuring the best of all five Bulls NBA championships. Plus, this collector's dream, a commemorative Bulls basketball. Both the great video and the championship basketball are free with your paid gift subscription to Sports Illustrated, the best way to light up a sports fan every week. Your gift video puts him courtside with the champion Bulls so he can relive those marvelous memories from championships past. To treasure forever the greatness of those teams. Their unforgettable heroics. Give your favorite fan the thrills he wants. The best of the Bulls five NBA championships. Plus, this Bulls Collector's Basketball, commemorating the Bulls five NBA championships. This great Spalding ball is a sure way to make points with your sports fan. And with Sports Illustrated, he'll receive an exciting new gift every week, all year long. This fine card will announce your gifts. Both great gifts are free with your order of 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.48 an issue. Save over 57% off the cover price. Use your credit card to get this special bonus, a limited edition five-time champion sports watch. It's the commemorative sports watch that just keeps on winning. Don't let them miss a memory.
Let the party begin.
One phone call gives them an unforgettable Bulls holiday gift pack. The great Bulls video, commemorative basketball, and sports watch. All three free from Sports Illustrated. Call now to make sure they get the best. Give Sports Illustrated. It's what they want.
It was a chilly day in Virginia Beach, but not chilly enough to keep these guys out of the water. They do have wetsuits on out there. Scoreboard, Hoskins trailing by 21, but he's working on a strike, and he gets to finish first.
Well, very important, Steve Hoskins with the opportunity to shoot 258. He gets the strikes in the ninth and 10th. And that lane, he gets the ball to come back on. As his whole family is loving it.
Well, he is now down 11.
If he strikes out and shoots 258, and Jason Couch now has a chance to still win with 279 if he punches out, but there's also an opportunity for a tie. And Little Monticelli can still shoot 252.
So, the thing is, to me, Hoskins wanted to finish first. This is his chance.
He says, that's one for me. That's the one he did not get in the title match against Monticelli.
And Amleto, as we're running a little behind, bowling his ninth frame right now, needs this to stay in the match. See, tough.
Oh, he's great. Look at that smile on his face. He feels good as he gets a little redemption for his bad shots on lane four.
Hoskins now. This would put him
in the 250s and would shut out Amleto Monticelli. But it won't shut out Jason Couch. He can't do that. Hook harder. Oh, my God. I can't believe it got back. Hoskins is going crazy out there.
Amleto was going to get up and bowl in the wrong lane, and they stopped him real quick.
That's okay, Amleto. I'm confused, too.
Yeah, we all are. Right now, Hoskins has basically eliminated Monticelli in this match, unless something disastrous happens.
Well, he needs
happened.
To get five pins. I think he can handle the five, but he wants them all to put a lot of pressure on Jason Couch. I think he liked that, Mike. What do you think?
Reminded me of a guy that I used to watch back in the 70s.
That's right.
That guy's sitting right next to me, I should say.
Lisa, Lindsay, and Ryan, very approving.
Very approving. Amleto.
Now the class act Amleto is. He can't win it, but he's trying. They'll give it a good finish.
Well, right now, Jason Couch has to get at least nine on this ball, or he'd be locked out.
Right now, Jason Couch is working in the 240s, needs to, like you said, at least get nine spare and then strike out to tie. This is the lane he's been high on, and that's the lane he's still high on. He did not make the adjustment on the right-hand lane.
But he's still in the match.
Still got a chance. Jason's been high flush on the left-hand lane, but on the right-hand lane, his ball was creeping high. He's tripped the six pin a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
Amleto finishing it out.
And he'll be in the 250s.
Jason at the six pin.
Must make it. All right. Kelly wants to know what the score is. I bet Jason knows.
All the bowlers know.
If Jason strikes out, he ties, there'll be a roll-off.
And we have some giant screens here. They're putting the score up on that so everybody in the arena can see that. Amazing Amleto. 252, if he strikes, he could finish third.
A great bowling. Well, it just came a little late, what we expected, Mike. The big scores.
And Jason Couch needing three strikes to tie and force a two-frame roll-off.
Well, he's finishing on his good lane. That redemption that he wanted, Mike Durbin, he'll have to earn it.
To stay alive.
Boy, has he got that lane wired.
Immediately following us, it's the Major League Players Choice Awards that'll be coming up from Orlando. It's time for the postseason awards, including Outstanding American and National League Players, Rookie and Man of the Year. That'll be coming up right after Jason does whatever he's going to do.
Well, if he doesn't get the strike, it won't be because he doesn't have confidence in this lane three.
It's been nothing but high flush on that lane. Every ball is just absolutely labeled deep in the pocket.
There it is, right down to the final ball, $10,000. This is just to stay alive.
To send it to a ninth and tenth frame roll-off.
A little in your face. Boy, what a great shot.
We'll be back with the roll-up after this break for a commercial. Don't you dare leave us now. Stay there.
Sometimes you need to take them away from the TV and video games, whether they want to leave or not. Because sometimes you can show them things they'll never find in their room at home. And sometimes you can teach them things that are worth learning just from you. And sometimes they can find something in themselves that they never knew they had. Bowling at BPAA Centers. It's a whole lot more than a game.
Clearview Lanes in Mount Joy.
Introducing Buick for 1998. This brand new breed of Buicks demands to be driven. Take a look at Buick now. It's our best Buick lineup ever. Make your statement in the elegant Park Avenue. Quiet, comfortable, and now with more standard luxury features at a surprisingly reasonable price. Under 1% financing or a great low lease rate. Park Avenue at your South Central Pennsylvania Buick dealers. This brand new breed of Buicks demands to be driven.
Want to go to the Super Bowl with ESPN? Play ESPN's Punt Pass and Win. Watch the Ravens versus the Steelers Sunday at 8. Tell us which team punted first and which team had the most passing yardage in the first half. And you could be going long all the way to San Diego. To score, call 1-800-643-8000 or touchdown on ESPN Sports Zone. Go behind the scenes with ESPN at the Super Bowl and win $1,000 from Visa. Play ESPN's Punt Pass and Win presented by Visa, the official card of the NFL.
It's the roll-off. Hoskins is spared in the ninth frame. Is his first shot of the 10th.
He hung in that ball a little bit, Mike. And he will not strike. The best he can do is 39. You got to like Jason Couch's chances. But Jason's going to have to combat that lane four that's given him just a little bit of trouble.
Cross lane at the 10 pin.
Don't give it to him, Steve. I'm afraid he might have.
Well, right now, Jason Couch just needs to mark in two frames to win.
Great shot from Jason Couch. All he needs right now is a mark. And if he throws this ball like he's been throwing it on the left-hand lane, he'll get that mark.
Jason Couch drying the hand, needing just a spare.
And he's had no trouble at all on this lane.
Jason Couch is the winner of the Ebonite Challenge. His redemption is drawing nigh. There's a reaction of the crowd. They loved it here at Virginia Beach. We love being with you. But we're going to have to leave you right at this, as Jason has won this and Amleto has won the tournament. So, for Marshall Holman, this is Mike Durbin saying so long from the pavilion in Virginia Beach, where Amleto is your champion and Jason Couch, the winner of the Ebonite Challenge. Coming up next is the Major League Baseball Players' Choice Awards. Be sure to join us next week from Hammerville, Pennsylvania, for the Bayer Brunswick Touring Players' Championship. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.